Hey, what's up everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and today I get to talk to you about one of my favorite features in all of 3D CAD, and that is the rib command in Onshape. Now, as a SolidWorks user moving into the world of Onshape, the rib command was one that's very important to me because I'm used to using it for parts that are 3D printed or for parts that are injection molded. So I really wanted to understand how it worked in Onshape. And now today I get to share what I've learned with you. So the rib command works very similar to an extrusion that goes up to next. You can see on this plastic part that I've got here of a fence post cover, I've got a plane that I've created that's kind of buried down in the part. And on that plane, I'm going to begin a sketch and create a simple rectangle. And this rectangle we can see here is going to be created with a width of 3 millimeters and a length of 40 millimeters. Now I'm going to jump into the extrude command, and for the end condition, I'm going to say up to next. And we can see that Onshape is able to terminate this by running it up to this angled face, the filleted face, and this bottom face of the part. So it's able to terminate it by running it up to next and running it into multiple faces. Well, the cool thing about the rib command is that it kind of follows that same idea, but it actually runs it up to next in three different directions. So once again, here's the plane for the rib, and I'm going to begin a new sketch there, and I'm just going to create a line very similar to the original extrusion that I created. But this time I'm going to exit that sketch and jump into a rib command. I'm going to say that the rib is 3 millimeters, and I'm going to select this line here as the rib profile. Now, once again, we can see that it's basically doing the same thing. It's just going up to next. But if I hit this check mark here that says extend profile to part, now we're getting an up to next in three different directions. And this is a really good way to think about the rib command because it's going up to next down in this direction, so kind of down to the bottom of the part. It's going up to next in this direction, extending that shortened sketch line. And it's also going up to next in this direction. So a rib goes up to next in three different directions. And the reason it's so beneficial to think of a rib in those terms is because a lot of times what I see users doing inadvertently is creating a rib in the wrong location. And what I mean by that is they will begin creating the sketch for their rib down here at the bottom of the part. So we create the sketch for the rib here at the bottom of the part, and we go to jump into the rib command, and it ends up failing. And the reason that it ends up failing is because there's nothing to terminate that up to next end condition. So you'll notice here, if I select on this line that I created at the bottom of the part and I reverse the direction of that rib feature, it's erroring. And let's see if I reverse again. See, look, now it's erroring, and we can kind of see why it's erroring. See, a rib always wants to go up to next in at least one direction, ideally in three directions. And what that means is that the rib always has to start up high and then kind of go down and into a pocket of some sort. We can't create the sketch for the rib at the very bottom of the pocket. And that's a common mistake that I see newer users doing when they try to work with the rib command. It's not going to work because there's no geometry to terminate that extrusion up to next, or that rib feature up to next. It has to be created up high and then run down into the pocket in order to terminate up to next. So just keep that in mind when you're deciding on the sketch plane for your rib command. Now, the next thing that I want to talk to you about is the idea of normal to sketch plane versus parallel to sketch plane. And everything we've done so far has been normal to sketch plane, meaning that it's extruding from the sketch plane in a perpendicular direction down into the part. But there is a second option when you're working with the rib command, and that is the parallel to sketch plane option. So if we look here at the right plane, which is bisecting this part, and we choose to begin a new sketch on that right plane, what we'll see is that we can create a line here that runs horizontal. Maybe I'll make this one just a little bit higher than the original ribs were created. And then with that line, we can jump into the rib command, and we can use this option for parallel to sketch plane. So we can use normal to sketch plane or parallel to sketch plane. And this time we can see that instead of the rib going perpendicular to the sketch plane, which would look something like this, there we can see it going perpendicular to the sketch plane. Instead, we can run that rib so that it kind of follows the sketch plane. It goes normal to the sketch plane. Now, once again, we can choose the option for extend profiles to part. That works really good. And if we want that rib to be merged to the existing solid, then we can use the option for merge ribs. If we uncheck that, we can see down here in our part studio that we're actually creating a second part with the geometry of the rib. Most of the time, you probably want that checked on. But now we can see that we're able to take this rib and run it up to next in three directions, following or running parallel to our right plane, which was our sketch plane. Now, the question becomes, when should I use one option versus the other? And the simple answer to that question is, if your rib, for some reason, needs to run on an angle, so in other words, if it's not supposed to be horizontal, but instead it needs to run at an angle, maybe something like this, when we hit the green check mark here to exit that sketch, we can see that that rib is able to run down at an angle. Well, you're really gonna need to use something like parallel to sketch plane in order to facilitate this, because, you know, if we're looking at our plane for the ribs, this would really all need to be planar. It would all need to follow that planar surface there. So anytime you need to create a rib that's running at an angle, you're probably gonna wanna use the option for parallel to sketch plane. On the other hand, there may be scenarios where you want to use the normal to sketch plane, and probably the most common example of that is when you're trying to do multiple ribs at the same time, or when you're trying to do a little bit more of a complex profile for that rib. So, for example, if we take a look at this sketch here, we could use that sketch to create a rib by jumping into the rib command and maybe selecting the circle here. That's gonna be a normal to sketch plane option. A circle is really not gonna work for a rib if you're using parallel to sketch plane, but it works no problem when you use normal to sketch plane. And also, if you're doing multiple ribs at the same time, you're most likely gonna be using the normal to sketch plane option. So we can see here, if I pick this sketch entity and this sketch entity, this sketch entity, and this sketch entity, I can get all four ribs at the same time. And once again, if I use this option for extend profile to parts, I'm getting that up to next in three directions. So up to next going up to the circle, up to next going away from the circle, and up to next going down to the bottom of the part. And that is my review of the rib command. It's a very cool command. It's got a lot of applications, and it can really help you when you're doing plastics design or designing parts for 3D printing. But let me know down in the comments below, what did you think about this overview? Did you learn anything new about the rib command? Do you have any questions? And of course, if you're enjoying this series, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, and be sure to join us for the next video.